On today's Product Spotlight episode, we're going to take a look at enriched categories. Hello everyone, I'm Adam from Akeneo, and I'm excited to share this one with you because it's a feature that I've heard many users request over the years, and now it's here. Enriched categories lets you provide those same high-quality experiences you're already building for your products, but at the category level. This lets you handle descriptive information for larger groups of products, things like collections, product lines, even chapters for digital and print catalogs. But maybe most importantly, enriched categories helps you manage SEO, which many brands like to do within categories. Let's take a look at how this feature fits into the Akeneo data model. Don't worry, don't be scared by the words data model. I promise we'll keep it simple. We start with a product, a light. We have some product attributes that describe this light. This light is part of a larger collection of products, which we can see here. This collection of products is stored in Akeneo as a category. And it is here that we can see our enriched category feature, which allows us to create attributes at that category level to describe the overarching collection. Let's see it in the system. Here I am in the application under settings and categories. I've honed in on my e-commerce category tree, and we're gonna take a look at enriched categories in action by looking at this sofas regal line category. So think of this as a line of sofas, maybe 15 different sofas that are part of a product line that are all stored in the same category. So I click on this category, and you can see that there are attributes describing the category. There's a long description. Envision a category tree within an e-commerce platform, and there's a description of this line of sofas. There's a short description version of it as well. We have a URL slug. We know that providing that URL slug can help our SEO engines hone in on our category pages, so we're able to provide that. We have different images. I love this one. This is an image of the designer of the line that provides more of that experience that customers want. We could maybe even tell a little story about her. There are also these back-end attributes that we can maintain here. We have meta title, meta description, keywords, all quite useful. Scrolling back up to the top, you can see we can adapt this information across locale, so we can handle translations and contextualizations, and we can do the same at the channel level. So we can adapt this information based on where we're selling our products. So this is what it looks like at that category level. Let's see how we actually build them. So we're gonna go back to categories, and now I am at the top level of my category trees. It's important to understand enriched categories live at that top level, that top node. Here we have a marketplace, and you can see there's a button, edit template. This is where I define my enriched categories. Clicking on that, I have two options. On the left, I can load a pre-built template. This template is based on our team's research talking to many different brands, and it gives you a list of common attributes that most brands find useful. You can do that. You can adapt that if you want. Alternatively, you can select the second button and build your attributes from scratch within that category. So when I do that, I'm taken to this screen and I build my attributes just like I would build my product attributes. So there's a label, there's a code, I have three different attribute types to select from, and I can configure it to have a different value across channel and locale as well. So that is enriched categories. I will note for my technical users, there are API endpoints that you can leverage to take advantage of this feature. Thank you very much for joining us on this product spotlight session. We hope to see you at the next one, and check out the description for some additional helpful links. Thank you.